The history of human habitation in the Sahara Desert is a complex and intriguing subject. The desert is one of the harshest environments on Earth, and yet it has been home to humans for thousands of years. The Sahara has gone through periods of being much wetter and more hospitable to human life in the past, and understanding these changes can give us insight into the lives of the people who have lived there throughout history. Archaeological evidence suggests that the Sahara was once a lush savanna, with rivers, lakes, and abundant vegetation. This wetter climate allowed for the development of human settlements, and evidence of early human habitation in the desert dating back to around 10,000 BC has been found. These early human societies were able to survive by hunting, gathering, and fishing, and they likely also practiced some form of agriculture. As the climate gradually became drier, these early human settlements had to adapt to the changing conditions. They likely moved to areas where water was still available, such as near oases or along the Nile River. They also developed new technologies, such as irrigation systems, to make the most of the limited water resources. Over time, the Sahara became increasingly inhospitable to human life, and by around 4,000 years ago, the majority of the desert was abandoned by human populations. However, pockets of human habitation persisted in certain areas, such as near oases and along trade routes. These communities developed unique cultures and ways of life that were well suited to the desert environment. The potential for underground water resources in the Sahara Desert is an area of ongoing research and exploration. While the desert is known for its lack of surface water, it is believed that there may be significant reserves of water located underground. One way that underground water can be found in the Sahara is through the use of aquifers. Aquifers are underground layers of rock that contain water and are able to store and transmit it. In the Sahara, there are several aquifers that have been identified, including the Nubian sandstone aquifer system, which is thought to contain one of the largest reserves of underground water in the world. Another way of finding underground water resources in the Sahara is through the use of drilling. This method involves drilling deep into the ground to reach the water table. However, this method is costly and may not be feasible in some areas of the desert due to the depth of the water table and the hardness of the rock. The impact of climate change on the Sahara Desert is an important and complex issue. The Sahara is one of the most sensitive regions to climate change, and its effects can be seen in various aspects of the desert such as temperature, precipitation, and vegetation. One of the most significant effects of climate change on the Sahara is the increase in temperature. The Sahara is already one of the hottest places on Earth, with temperatures regularly exceeding 40 degrees Celsius, 104 degrees Fahrenheit. However, climate change is causing temperatures to rise even further, making it even more difficult for people and wildlife to survive in the desert. The effects of human activities, such as mining and oil drilling, on the Sahara Desert and its inhabitants are a significant concern. The Sahara is a vast and remote area, and the impacts of human activities in the desert can be far-reaching and long-lasting. Mining is one of the most significant human activities that is affecting the Sahara. The desert is rich in minerals such as gold, phosphate, and uranium, and these resources are highly sought after for use in industry and technology. However, mining can have negative impacts on the desert's ecosystems and the people who depend on them. For example, mining operations can cause soil erosion, water pollution, and loss of biodiversity, as well as displacement of local communities. Oil drilling is another human activity that is affecting the Sahara Desert. The desert is believed to contain significant reserves of oil and natural gas, and the extraction of these resources can have major impacts on the desert's ecosystems and the people who live there. Oil spills and other accidents can cause serious pollution and damage to the desert's fragile ecosystems, while the construction of pipelines and other infrastructure can disrupt the lives of local communities. The potential for renewable energy development in the Sahara Desert is an area of ongoing research and exploration. The desert is one of the sunniest places on Earth, and harnessing its abundant solar energy resources has the potential to provide a significant source of clean and sustainable energy for the region and the world. One of the most significant renewable energy resources in the Sahara is solar power. The desert receives an average of around 3,000 hours of sunshine per year, making it an ideal location for solar power plants. There are several solar energy projects currently under development in the Sahara, including large-scale solar power plants and small-scale solar systems for remote communities. Another renewable energy resource in the Sahara is wind power. The desert is also home to some of the strongest and most consistent winds on Earth, which can be harnessed to generate electricity through wind turbines. The impact of tourism on the Sahara Desert is an important and complex issue. The desert is a unique and fascinating destination that attracts millions of visitors each year, but tourism can also have negative impacts on the desert's ecosystems and the people who live there. One of the main impacts of tourism on the Sahara Desert is the strain it can put on the desert's fragile ecosystems. The desert is home to a wide variety of plant and animal life that has adapted to survive in the harsh conditions, and tourism can disrupt these ecosystems in a variety of ways. For example, off-road vehicles used by tourists can damage delicate desert habitats, while overcrowding in popular tourist spots can lead to the degradation of natural resources. The effects of desertification on the local population and their livelihoods in the Sahara Desert is an important and pressing issue. Desertification is the process by which fertile land becomes desert, and it is a significant problem in the Sahara and other arid regions. One of the main causes of desertification in the Sahara is overgrazing. Livestock is a crucial source of livelihood for many people in the desert, but when there are too many animals grazing on the same land, they can overuse and degrade the vegetation. This can lead to soil erosion and loss of fertility, making it increasingly difficult for plants to grow and animals to survive. The diversity of plant and animal life in the Sahara Desert is a fascinating and unique aspect of the desert's ecosystems. Despite the harsh conditions of the desert, a wide variety of species have adapted to survive in the Sahara, and understanding these species can give us insight into the desert's ecology and how it has changed over time. The cultural and spiritual significance of the Sahara Desert to the peoples who have lived there throughout history is an important aspect of understanding the desert and its place in the world. The Sahara has been home to a diverse array of cultures and civilizations throughout history, and these cultures have developed unique perspectives on the desert and its meaning. The role of the Sahara in global climate patterns and its influence on weather patterns in other regions is an important and complex issue. The Sahara is the largest hot desert in the world, and its size and location make it a significant player in global climate patterns.